Hello everyone, today I would like to delve into what IMC is once more, covering part 4, the health of intermetallic compounds. Please note that this presentation is for personal sharing, and the content might not be entirely accurate. For more information, you can visit the website at mpe.researchmfg.com. How do we judge the health of IMC? What is the ideal thickness for IMC? Well, there's a common misunderstanding that the thicker the IMC layer, the stronger the soldering strength. In reality, a uniform growth of the IMC layer at the interface location is sufficient. The thickness of the IMC is not the key factor for solderability. If the IMC layer becomes excessively thick, it can become brittle and reduce soldering strength. Just like I mentioned before that think of IMC as the cement between bricks, too much or unevenly applied cement can weaken the structure. We typically perform cross-sections and use EDS, energy dispersive X-ray spectroscopy, for inspecting the quality of IMC growth. So, what's the ideal IMC thickness? There isn't an industrial standard that defines IMC thickness as far as I know. In my personal opinion, a thickness of 1 to 3 micrometers for IMC is best, and a thickness of 1 to 5 micrometers is acceptable for tin copper and tin nickel IMC. Now, let's look at a diagram that illustrates how IMC thickness growth is proportional to temperature and inversely proportional to the square root of time. It shows the growth speed of IMC for tin gold, tin silver, tin nickel, and tin copper. Next, let's explore where IMC grows. In a cross-section picture of a soldered pin on a PCB. This is soldering pin. This is PCB. You can see the glass fiber here. And here is the solder. Where does the IMC grow? The IMC grows in two gray-colored locations, between the soldering pins and the solder, and between the PCB pad and the solder. What about IMC growth in BGA, ball grid array, soldering? This is another image, demonstrates the location of IMC growth in BGA soldering. Where does the IMC grow? You can see the IMC marked in white. This picture just shows you where the IMC locate. The actual IMC layer is very thin. Now, a closer look with a 1000x magnification reveals 4 IMC locations. Three of them show even and continuous growth, which is good. The fourth location's IMC growth isn't as ideal, as it appears thin and may be prone to breaking. However, it's still acceptable. In a picture of BGA soldering, you can see good IMC growth marked by evenness. while poor IMC growth appears uneven. All right, this concludes the fourth video to introduce the IMC. This is the final video about the IMC concepts. For more information, please visit mpe.researchmfg.com. Have a great day. Goodbye.